set up, we said. Stand the ball pretty quickly. Fair. The back was a little bit curved, but that's probably more questions. Sort of, back a bit. And as we get older, the back will get a bit. But overall, pretty good position to start with. Okay. As that swing went back, what we're trying to encourage obviously is a little bit less lower half movement. Your left foot was moving very early and a lot. Okay. Now, when you get there, you're losing a bit of balance. Okay. If we can try and make it being a little bit less movement going back, it's still going to have a little bit to say. But at least here now, it's not moving as much. See. It will move as a result of you turning the body back on the way back, okay? If it doesn't move there, if you've got the same position there, that's how much that left foot's moved there.
Yeah.
You're almost off the ground there, aren't you?
Yeah.
So that's just a lot of movement. The knees come over too much. You've lost some stability.
Yeah.
So when it starts moving now, it's just helping us initiate the backswing at the end of the sort of backswing.
Yeah.
Rather than sort of moving very early and very independently, okay?
Yeah, yeah.
The key thing then we said when you got the top of the backswing now, you couldn't move left and you were trying to keep your head down, as you said. So as you came back to the golf ball now, that drop back, weight is on your back foot, ball would often go in left or pulled or topped. This foot we can see now lifting off the ground. And I think from a physical standpoint, at this position here now, just try and imagine sort of your skeletal structure. You've got your shoulders basically facing the target, full 90 degree twist. Your eyes are looking down there and your hips are there. And the top of your spine, your head's doing that, your head's down there, your hip, that's going to be a bit of a crunch up there. At some point, on that sort of thing down the back of you, there's going to be a bit of a twinge or a pinch or something that's going to cause some issues there, okay? Compare that to this one here now when you swing through, okay? Twisting through. Look at that. That same position, your eyes are kind of going with it.
Yeah.
The belt buckle now we can see is is turned to target there as the shoulders. So your hips are there, your shoulders and hips are there now, and your eyes are. So there to me now looks a lot more connected in terms of where your movement is.
Yeah.
And your right foot now, look at the movement now of your lower half. That to me is a golf swing, isn't it? And from a health standpoint, this is why I say many golfers I teach, whether it's someone like myself, something like Georgia, it's about getting a consistent, healthy golf. A repeatable movement is not going to be destructive, okay?
Yeah.
This position here now, that to me, look, if your left foot's reacting in such a way and all your weight's with the right foot, this hip's not going to move at all. It can't. There's no movement there for the ball at all. So your head's staying down, top shoulders moving fully as they are.
Yeah.
Back, by the time you get to about hold 10, 11, 12, you're like 10 rounds of Tyson. So no wonder you, and hopefully by seeing that, you can now see, okay, It's going to hurt for that reason.
Yeah.
So trying to keep it here, but all the things you're potentially trying to do was causing more pain, wasn't it?
Yeah.
So allowing that body to rotate. Yeah. So I'd certainly encourage, where possible, that movement where you sort of stand to the ball end, say living at home and brushing your teeth, and just get that hip movement there.
Yeah.
So that becomes pretty much sort of second nature.
Yeah.
It'll just become a natural move that you will do over and over again.
Yeah.
Okay. The more you get that hip thrown through the ball there, the better it's going to be.
Yeah.
Okay, does that make sense?
Yeah.
Good stuff.
Yeah, totally.
Okay.